Hey everybody, my name is Alex and I'm the owner of Goldilocks Automotive. Today we are doing radiant heat test on some of the gold thermal tapes on the market. Now, there are a few videos online, including our own, using open flames to test the tape. This is a pretty destructive test and doesn't really replicate the conditions of an engine bay. Here we have three different samples of the tape. In the top left is our Elite Series thermal tape, capable of resisting 1000 degrees Fahrenheit. At the top right is the eBay cheap stuff. The bottom left is DEI Reflect-A-Gold, and the bottom right is the Control Bare Metal. They all look similar, but how will they fare? To do the testing, we have two pieces of equipment. The first is a trusty heat gun. This will deliver our source of radiant heat. And our second piece of equipment is a temperature sensor connected to an Arduino and an LCD display. This will allow you guys to see, in real time, the temperature changes. Here you can see that this heat gun gets the temperature sensor to about 135 degrees Celsius, which is the approximate heat range of most engine bays. First up, let's take a look at the control. All the results will be posted at the end of the video in a chart for a better comparison of how they did. Each sample was placed in the vise with the temp sensor touching it. It was then heated for 30 seconds. Each of these clips are at double speed. Next up is the eBay cheap stuff. Each sample is only one layer on the metal panel. Next, we have the DEI tape. Finally, we have our Goldilocks Automotive Elite Series. Our tape is thicker than the competitors because it has a stronger polyamide layer, the gold reflective part, a thicker layer of aluminum to help dissipate the heat, and a tighter glass weave on the back. This means that you have better protection to keep the radiant heat out of your airflows and your cooling system. Now, here are the results, and I think they speak for themselves. You'll want to look at the last column, which is the delta, or the difference, between the starting temperature and the ending temperature for each sample. What's surprising is how poorly the cheap eBay stuff fares. It reflects only 3% of the radiant heat. You might as well put paper on your engine bay. DEI did okay, reflecting a little over 20% of the radiant heat, but it came nowhere close to performing as well as our Elite Series, which reflected 46% of the radiant heat. That's twice as good as DEI. To purchase Elite Series and for more in-depth information, visit GoldilocksAutomotive.com.